So, hello. Hello. So, I was thinking, like, what exactly are hallucinogenic trips, right? Explore on human consciousness. So, every time you, So, in life, you're given your physical body, right, and your imagination. And in life... In life, that's all there is to life, is that you're given a physical body, what you need to do, you need to eat, whatever, who you are, because it's created by your imagination, right? In life, you're given a physical body and imagination, right? And in the physical body is a human consciousness, right? And in the consciousness, it creates what type of person you are, what you do, you know? Your projection of your imagination onto reality, right? So, exploring human consciousness. It's mind, body, spirit, soul, right? So what are hallucinogenic drugs, right? What exactly are hallucinogenic drugs in relation to spirituality? So, a lot of people deem psychedelic drugs as like a spiritual experience, right? A lot of people use chemicals. They use hallucinogenic chemicals to connect to the mind, body, and soul, right? They connect to the spiritual essence of what you are, right? Or life, or whatever in it. So every time you do a drug, you do a hallucinogenic drug. Like, where did you get the drug, right? In nature, is the creation of nature, and is it the creation of life? Why would there be hallucinogenic drugs? Why would there be hallucinogenic drugs for you to use? However you extracted the chemical and however it affects you. Let's say if I go out and I want a trip on psychedelic drugs, right? And I did it, right? And in the experience, I deem it as a spiritual experience. I awoke to something higher than the physical, right? So, every time you do a psychedelic drug, you're altering your brain physically, right? You do a drug in real life. I take shrooms or whatever, and I alter my brain physically, right? And that's all that happens from the outside, is that he does a drug and changes the chemistry of his brain, and he experiences the change, right? Whatever you did to you. He experiences the what exactly altered your brain physically, right? And how it alters your human consciousness at the time, right? So our trips. So what is imagination? It's exactly what life is. So what is imagination? Is that you're given a human consciousness, right? And all you're given in life is a human body. It's a physical body that in thought, right? And in thinking, every time you provoke a thought in your use of it, it creates your imagination, right? And this is exactly creates like what a dream is. So every time you have a dream, you're exploring your human consciousness, right? So in the dream, you dream somewhere, right? In the dream, there are subconscious portalway, there are subconscious gateway to whatever exists in it, right? So you open your you open yourself up to this portal way of existence, and the existences of your memories, your subconscious memories, whatever you store, whatever your brain stores, like a memory, right? Your thinking, it creates what thinking is. So in the realm of imagination, of thought, in the realm of thought, thinking, it creates what life is. It's exactly what life is, right? You're given a human consciousness, and you're thinking. And, yeah, and in the thinking, you open yourself up to the realm of your thinking, right? It's the realm of thinking. It's the realm of thought. What exists in your thoughts is a byproduct of your memory. It's a product of your memory, right? And in your memory, your memories are your thoughts, right? So, before you've experienced a memory and you go back in time before you experienced it, you can't think of it, right? You can't think of something before it subconsciously exists in your memory, right? In your thought of your physical brain storing something you experience as a thought, right? And what creates a thought is like, if you have a psychedelic trip, then it creates what the psychedelic trip is, right? You physically alter the chemistry of your brain, you get high or whatever, you take a drug, and you physically alter your brain, right? And therefore, anything you trip is a product of your imagination, right? But the product of your imagination, or is the question. Are you really going beyond the physical into the infinite world of spirit, right? In the infinite realm of spirit, right? Or in the infinite realm of imagination, it contains whatever, right? So, if you have a trip, if you have a psychedelic trip and you alter your brain physically, what is happening is that you, during the physical experience of you altering your brain because of the drug, what happens to your human consciousness is that you experience whatever, right? Whatever you're experiencing is based off of your imagination, right? Whatever you experience is based off of your imagination because you're opening a portal way to when you alter your brain physically, your human consciousness explores that world of imagination, right? So if you do a drug and you alter your brain physically, and what happens to whatever you do on the drug, whatever you experience, is that you open the portal way to this realm, right? To this spiritual realm of imagination. And I believe that imagination is a portal way. It's a realm. It's a spiritual realm of its own, right? So if you think of something or somebody, if you think of something, then it's a non-physical thought, but it's entirely based off of like however you thought of it. You can't think of something before it exists for your subconscious to use, right? So what happens when you alter your brain physically and you do a hallucinogenic drug, right? You alter your brain physically, and during that time your physical consciousness is altered. And in that time, your consciousness is opening, it's accessing the vault of your subconscious, right? Of your imagination, right? What happens when you get high off of LSD or shrooms? If I got high off of shrooms and I was tripping hard, right? I was seeing it. So every time you open the portal way into the realm of imagination, right? What contains what does this realm contain, right? It's infinity. And infinity is there, right? So imagination is a tool to access what you can possibly imagine. What exists, what infinitely exists in this imagination is what creates what life is, right? It creates soul, it creates spirit, it creates who you are in the physical body, right? So who you are, what you are, the spirit of your physical body is created by your imagination, right? It's created by our human consciousness. Your conscious, your physical body your physical body contains imagination, right? And every time you open your world up to the imagination, you're exploring human consciousness in some way. And for example, I just used is that you do a psychedelic drug. What happens when you physically alter yourself and you deem it as a spiritual experience? When all you did was get high, right? All that happens is that you got high. As I went out and I did shrooms, right? And all that happened is that you changed the chemistry of your brain because of the reaction of the drug that you did. Whatever happens in your brain is that it becomes a product of your subconsciousness, right? It becomes a product of your memories. So every time you have a trip, you're accessing the vault of your memories, right? You're opening a portal way to the vault of existence in your subconsciousness, right? And in that subconsciousness, in the vault is the realm, right? It's a spiritual realm, right? It's what it creates, what life is, right? So if you sit there and you create music, right? You create art based off of whatever. You're digging deep in that realm. Of every time you see a piece of art, every time you draw art, art is based off of, it's derived from the realm of imagination, right? You're digging deep. You're opening you open the door, right, to the infinite possibilities of what you can imagine, right? It creates what spirit is. It's exactly what your human consciousness hooks on to what you are physically. It creates soul, right? So what happens if I was correct? What happens if I'm correct, right? An imagination is a realm of spirit, right? It's a spiritual realm. It's non-physical, right? And an imagination projects itself into reality, right? It's exactly what reality is. It's exactly what creates what life is. It's a projection of thought, right? It's art, right? You can't think of something before it exists in your mind to you. So where does it exist, right? So what is art? What is art, right? It's a projection of your imagination, and every time you look into this realm of imagination, you're digging deep into what you are, right? As a spirit, right? You're digging deep into spirit, right?